Welcome to Metal Canyon's channel.
Welcome, everyone. Welcome to another Let's Play. This is Metal Canyon, and we'll be playing Train Mechanic Simulator 2015. I've been waiting for this for quite a while, because I have a series on Car Mechanic Simulator 2015 on my channel, which you might have been watching or might not have. I've been really excited about this because you work on trains, and come on, trains are just cool. I hope this music is all theirs and not licensed. Anyway, yes, this will be a completely blind playthrough of Train Mechanic Simulator 2015. How do I create a profile? And hopefully, do I just start a new game? I don't know. And hopefully it's going to be as much fun as Car Mechanic Simulator 2015. Welcome to the game, Train Mechanic Simulator, or Train Mechanic 2017. You're a train mechanic and your task will be to repair rail vehicles in three different workshops. Ooh. Under your care, we'll be both archaic and simple steam engines, as well as very modern electric locomotives. Oh, that's cool. Each locomotive will be assigned to a garage adapted to repair its respective type. Good luck. Alright. Well, first of all, the graphics are surprisingly good. I was not expecting that. I saw some screenshots of this game before it, before it released. It's actually not released yet. You'll be able to get it on, I believe, the 23rd of March. So, in about a week, you'll be able to get it. Oh, work order. Oh, yeah, in the top left, we have job order. Let's see. Go to the office and accept our work. Okay. Right, well, English translation, not the best, but that's fine. Work order. Welcome to the work order acceptance system. Here you will be able to accept work orders, missions assigned to a given workshop. In this window, you can switch between work orders to skip a given task and possibly finish it later. Well, see, this was proper English. Job order number one. Welcome to the game, Train Mechanic 2017. Your first mission will be a simple train repair so you can become familiar with the basics of the game. Your task will be repairing a locomotive in which the steel and rubber springs in the front truck have been damaged. Income 250, bonus 500. That's it? Okay. Let's accept this. Oh, there's the locomotive. I thought it would be loading. Bloody hell. It appears that the cause of the locomotive's malfunction is a damaged carriage. Probably they are the steel and rubber springs. Locate the exact cause of the defect and replace with a new part. Okay, two parts not found. So this is the same as in Car Mechanic Simulator. For example, minimum condition of the parts, that's the same. Estimated cost of the order, 11,000. Bloody hell, well, these are locomotives. Now, the cool thing is, to complete the order, okay. Now, the cool thing is, while I know a bit about cars, I know very little about how locomotives are put together. Bloody hell. That's cool. I was not expecting this much graphical fidelity. I mean, it's, you know, it's no, it's not it's not an absolutely amazing thing, but it's very pretty. I mean, I cannot be unfair to the game. It's very, very pretty. For a, you know, for a game, for a niche game like this, you wouldn't expect graphics to be really that pretty. I mean, personally, I really like it. So anyway, I think I can already see some rust. Does it work the same way? In this mode, you can strip down locomotives, taking apart all their available components. Often to be able to get to a part, you will need to remove other parts, even those operating properly. Please remember about this. We know that. Oh, that is nice. And there's also nice glowing stuff. Let's see, steel and rub. Wait, that's the stuff they wanted me to do, right? Steel and rubber springs. There we go. So it does work like in Car Mechanic Simulator. If it's rusty, it probably needs to be... Oh, there we go. It probably needs to be replaced. Oh, that's cool. I like the animation. Oh, there we go. Man, these are some huge things. There we go. I think that's it, right? Let me see. Job order. Steel and rubber springs. There we go. It's not a known item anymore. Right. Tablet. The tablet is your information center. Here you can start online stores with Wait, you can start online stores with parts? You mean browse. There are three shops for mechanics, hydraulics, and electrical systems. Improve your garage and go to the Mechanics Help Center that describes all of the operations in the game. Wow, that's cool. Help improve the workshop. Wow, we're not gonna do that just now. Wait, what are these? Oh, the... Wait, repair workbenches? Specific sub-assemblies may be repaired on the workbenches. We have divided them into three categories: mechanics, hydraulics, and electrical. The cost of the repair will be added to the account. The difficulty is that there is no certainty as to the success of the repair. If the repair is successful, this part will be repaired in a percentage of 90 to 100%. If, however, we don't manage to regenerate the part, I like that. Regenerating the part, it will be even more damaged. The horror. The price of repair is significantly lower than the purchase of new parts. The more improved the workbench, the greater the chance of repairing more complex parts. Oh, it's the wrong workbench. This is electrical. This is mechanics. What's the next one? Hydraulics? Yeah. Texas oil. I like that. There we go. 4,000 to repair it. Oh man, I have to remember that I work on bloody locomotives now. Chance of success. Look at that. Of course, it's tutorial. Repair the other one. How much are the new ones, I wonder? So this was about 8,000 to repair all together. Steel and rubber. This mechanical, I guess. Steel. Oh, there they go. 6,000. Okay. Well, they were very damaged, but we managed to save. Oops, we managed to save about 4,000 bucks. That's nice. Right, let's put them back. Installation mode. That's the same as in Car Mechanic Simulator. In this window, you can manage your spare parts. You can sell them, then profit from the resale will decrease the amount of the account. What? The better parts condition, the more profit you generate from it. You can sell them, then profit from the resale. Will decrease the amount of the account. Shouldn't the profit from the resale increase the amount in my account? I don't know. Either way, I'm not going to be complaining about the English translation, because most of it is actually pretty good. Let's put the other one in. Oh man, this is so exciting. I don't know why, but I'm working on bloody locomotives. I always was interested in locomotives or driving them. I mean, obviously never have driven any. It looks like everything is already repaired. You can finish the task from the work order sheet. You can find new work orders or on the order table in the office. Or I can just press this, right? There we go. Finish order. Yeah. Look at that. It's done. Bonus for low cost. Oh, we get bonus for low cost as well. Because we repaired the parts. Nice. All right. So, next job order. Let's see. Go to the office and accept a work. Okay, I'll accept a work. Man, I'm... Job order number two. The driver complains about a faulty brake system. Locate the cause of the defect and make repairs. This work order is slightly more difficult. Remember that each part type is repaired on a different workbench. If you're not able to repair the part yourself, you can buy a new part from the store using the tablet. Okay. I have to... Wow. There's no loading like it was in Car Mechanic Simulator. That is really nice. I also have to say, I really like... Obviously, apart from the graphics, I really like how the game controls. It's very, you know, smooth. There's no fighting the camera or anything. Oh, there's the hydraulic brake piston. How do I take that? Oh, disassembly mode. Ah, I need to take off the hydraulic brake hoses. Can I... Thank you. I'm still not sure. If I click on it, it doesn't seem to do it. If I click and hold it, then it seems to take stuff apart. Let me try that again. So if I click... No. If I click... Oh, it selects that particular piece. And then if I click on it again... Okay. So it's basically a double click, right? Yeah. That might get a little bit annoying. And that was three parts already. Oops. I believe that's all of them, right? Yep. Right, let's see. Two mechanical things and a hydraulic part. 9%. That's probably not gonna work. Ooh, 31% chance of success. See, I really like this. In Car Mechanic Simulator... Ah. I failed. There was not really any way you could truly lose money. Unless you did it, you know, wanting to lose money. 31%, 3,000. But here you actually have to decide whether you want to try to repair something or not. I like that. So, break caliper arm. Wait. Brake caliper, caliper arm, and hydraulic brake piston. Okay. So let's do the brake caliper. That one, and the arm. Oh! So now you add it to cart. That's nice. Let's buy that. I can continue shopping. How do I go to the previous stuff? Oh, I need the hydraulic stuff. Okay, let's order that. Account status after the work order. Is this my... how much I have left? Probably. Hydraulics. I need the... brake piston. I think. Ooh. Am I in the red? I'm not sure. Alright. So now we put this back together. Uh-oh. Oh, no, no, it wasn't the brake piston. What am I doing? You... oh, bloody hell. Moron. Great. Okay, so there's a brake caliper. Wait a second, it was the brake piston. What am I talking about? No, I'm not a moron, I'm a genius! I was a little bit too fast there. I'm judging myself. There we go. And now the hose thing, right? The brake hoses. There we go, that's complete. Jump order. Finish order. Nice. I like how fast it is. There's no loading, annoying loading like it was in Car Mechanic Simulator. And I probably should stop comparing the two now. And just enjoy the game. And hopefully you're enjoying this as well, because bloody hell, I am. Sometimes the tasks will involve finding and repairing locomotives that were damaged somewhere on the routes of the game world, and then towing off them to the appropriate workshops and making repairs. For this purpose, you'll use a special repair train. This time, a diesel locomotive broke down in square D1. Locate it and tow it to the workshop. We suspect a truck failure. D1. Oh, so this is the part of the game where you can actually drive the trains. How do I just go out? Exit from the garage. Okay, yes. So this is the part that has me a bit worried. They haven't spent... well, actually, I don't think I'm worried. Because I was worried that they would spend too much time on the driving part instead of... oh, wow. Instead of the actual mechanic part. D1. Oh, wow. I have to say, the graphics are very pretty for such a game. Very pretty. Okay, increase engine power, decrease braking, rotating horn. Oh, yeah. I like it. Let's go. Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. What's all that? Westport, road to the diesel engine. What? What is this? Can I click on this? Oh! Oh, it's the switchboard. Wait, where am I going? They said D1, right? Can I... there we go. I can brake. Oh, wow. D... four, three, oh! Oh, wow. We have to go all the way over here. D1. How do we get there? This is showing me... what? Oh, this is showing me where I will go with the current switches thing? I think. Alright, let's just keep going. Pedal to the metal! Actually, I wonder, can you go too fast and derail? Let's find out. Let's see, do I go... oh, there we go. Yep, yep, yep. It's telling us where we'll go. So now we're going to the right. Okay. Nope, can't seem to derail. Wait, C. Oh, that's cool. There's even an inside. I'm actually surprised they spent a lot of effort doing all of this. We're going through trees, but that's fine. You know, just doing the actual cockpit and everything. Oh, wait, we'll need to go left there. This is kind of cool. It's like a bit of a puzzle. Can't really derail, so no point in going slower, I guess. I think I want... oh, I can't go right. Wait, there we go. There. Yes, that's where I want to go. Or maybe I want to go around there. Music's changed. I do like this. And I've got a horn! Let's go to the right there, please. I wonder if the suspension is doing anything. Nope. Doesn't seem like it. Okay, we're getting to the part where we're supposed to... Where is that train? Oh, there we go. We are at the right place. How do I... Oh, it's there! It's there! Break! Oh, what happened? Tow the train to the diesel train depot. Oh, do we have it in tow? Yeah, we do! Alright, let's go! Well, I can go there. I guess, yeah. Let's go down there. Pedal to the metal. I guess we could go in reverse as well, but... I didn't even notice this bloody crane. Look at it. Oh. To lift entire trains, I guess? That's quite interesting. I like this sort of Wild West place here. Also, the music is kind of westerny. Wild westerny. Oh, yeah. Horn, of course. What's that? Is that where we're supposed to go? Wait. Steam locomotive depot. That's the steam engine depot. There we go. So I'm assuming that's the diesel one? Diesel engine depot. Yep, that's where we came from. Okay. That's pretty cool. Hold on, everyone. Trains are coming. Yeah. I have to say, so far, this game is proving to be quite polished, actually. No crashing, no bugs. I mean, it's very early, of course, to say. We've been playing for, 17 minutes? But, yeah, the impressions are very good. I'm happy. It doesn't seem like they skimped on the actual mechanics part. I mean, if anything, they skimped a little bit on the simulation part here. Driving, but, you know. I'd much rather... Oh, there's another train there. I'd much rather them skimp on this part, because it is called the Train Mechanic Simulator. You know, I wouldn't want a half-assed mechanic part. Wait. We need to go right there. Right, and then down there, yes. Oh, look. Windmills. Windmills. Man, it's weird seeing the train... Oh. Turn at such sharp corners, at such speeds. What can I say? I'm a kid. I need the horn. Alright, to the right there and then left. Okay, it's already all switched. I guess the train tracks stay switched like you left them. What are these villages? Look, it's like a Norse village or something there. Alright, so now we're gonna be repairing this train that we are towing behind us. Can I just leave it? Yeah. Damaged vehicle had been stored properly and towed into workshop. Or into the workshop. Either way. Yeah, I'm happy. There's very little loading. Where it is, it's very quick. Just as we expected, the problem proved to be damaged transmission in the truck. Remove and replace them. Right. So this is the truck. Can I go... Actually, can I go up there? No. Body. What's that? Oh! Oh, that's... Cool. I like it. Not really sure what purpose that serves, because as soon as you start doing this, everything disappears anyway. Wait. Can I... Oh, you can do stuff with the engine as well. Look at all those cylinders. That's a V16 engine. Oh, man. I like it. Okay, anyway. Let's see. There's a bloody fuel tank. Oh, man. Of course, it needs a lot of fuel. Right, there's the parts. Drive gear. What's that? Electric motor rotor tip shaft. Oh, it just comes off. And that one as well. Oh, that's the electric motor. There we go. Recover. That's quite big. Let's take that off. And that... Oh! Is that it, actually? Yeah, it is. It's only the drive gear. Right, I'm assuming I won't be able to repair this. Oh, wow. 40,000 to repair these things. And 5% chance of success. Yeah, let's burn the money, shall we? Right, so drive gear it is. Drive gear? Oh, you can't press enter. You have to... 46. Oh, man. 92,000. Where am I getting the money from? Oh, I have... What? I don't understand. Can I see how much money I have? I don't quite understand this. This is the work order. How do I check how much money I have? Not really sure. Condition, parts warehouse, tablet. Help. This is nice. Okay, never mind. I'll figure it out later. Right now, we gotta put those things back together. And I have no idea about these things. I only know what a diesel electric is on a train. But apart from that, I know very little about trains. So now we're going to learn, I guess. Because hopefully, like with Car Mechanic Simulator, it's fairly accurate. Of course, simplified, but fairly accurate. As to, you know, what's put together on a train. Income, bonus for complete achievement, and bonus for low cost, which we didn't do because, man, it was expensive. And even if we did manage the 5% to repair it, we would have only saved like 200 bucks or something, because they were pretty much trashed. The main railway station informed us that a locomotive pulling passenger cars has not arrived on time. Check what happened. Alright, let's do that then. Oh yeah, we have to go and get the train again. Leave the garage. Yes. Oh man, we'll get steam trains as well. There's three different parts. Diesel electric. E4. E4. Oh, that's right there. Okay. So let's see. The diesel engine. The steam engine. And the electrical engine. Okay. That's cool. Right. Pedal to the metal. Yeah. Look at those buildings over there. Right. So we want to go forward. Straight ahead. Well, sort of. It's not really straight, is it? But there we go. I actually kind of wanted to be a train driver at some point. Kind of do so now as well, but, you know, pipe dreams and all of that. Right, so there should be E4. This is E4. There should be a derailed train somewhere. Oh, there. Oh, it's actually over there. Okay. Hello, Mr. Train. Press X to start crane mode. We're actually going to use the crane now? Okay, boom, rotate, height, line, rotating an object, attach a hook. Okay. Right, that's that. Height. Alright, let's do this. Man, the whole thing actually rotates. That's pretty cool. Ah, there's the hooking point. We have to get it there. Oop. That's cool. Press C to hitch the hook. Ah! Okay, so we have to put it back on the rails now, I'm assuming. And hopefully not hit that tree and not damage the train further. Man, it's lifting the entire train. So now I'll have to rotate it so it won't... No, wait. I think it's rotating it on its own. Yeah. It's keeping it in the same direction we picked it up. That's kind of cool, actually. How far can this thing extend, this boom? That's crazy. And not tip over. Don't they have, like, some sort of fastening things? Okay, let's... it's nice that it's showing me where the train will go. Should actually rotate the camera a little bit. No, that's quite good. Let's go. Oh, and it's done. And we can go back, tow the train to the diesel depot. And I'm just gonna go in reverse, because we're right there. And hopefully I don't need to switch any tracks, because I believe that's that. That is cool. I have to say, graphics, very nice, as I said before. You know, this stuff is a little simplified, but it's fine. I'm completely fine with that. It's cool that you can also operate the crane. And I'm just looking forward to taking apart the trains. And especially the steam ones, probably. Also electric. Well, actually, all of them. Did you see those bloody cylinders? V16 engines. How cool is that? And we can do stuff from the inside. This monitor is off for some reason. And this one has all the switchboards. Looks pretty crazy. Oh, wait. Where are we going? Okay. Oh, yeah. I don't even have to brake. Damaged vehicle had been restored properly. Wait, it's been restored? Okay. So I don't have to repair it then. Just kidding. We're gonna repair it right now. It appears that the problem is damaged engine mountings in both trucks. Oh, both trucks. Okay. So damaged engine mountings. Is that for... Oh, it's these ones. Yeah, engine mounting. That's cool. So it derailed because of this. I guess it started wobbling or something? I have no idea. I like the fact that the sound of the little screws... Well, little screws. Of the screws actually sounds like they're pretty big and heavy. Ah, now we'll have to take the electric motor... What? I didn't quite read it. Let's zoom in a bit. See the action. I'm really enjoying this game, I have to say. I never thought, you know, when I first started playing Car Mechanic Simulator, I thought it was pretty cool. But I never thought I would really be playing it for long. And now, you know, now we'll see where the series is. I think we're like part 60 or something. And I feel this is going to be the same. Because, come on, it's locomotives. It's cool. Engine mounting. Let's take all that apart. Oh, look at the shiny wheels. That's pretty cool. I also like how everything is not completely shiny and new looking. You know, even when you buy new stuff, it looks like it's a part of heavy machinery. Oh yeah, it's on the back as well, right? There's a lot more parts we have to find. It's these mounts as well that we'll need replacing. Look, they're all rusty. There we go. Take that off. That's what she said, I guess. Sorry, I'm just a kid. I can't do without those jokes. Even though YouTube doesn't like it. I wonder what... I mean, in Car Mechanic Simulator, you could do restorations, which meant you bought the used cars in pretty bad condition, and then you could restore them completely, which basically meant taking them fully apart. I wonder if something like that is going to be going on here. I kind of doubt it, you know, considering it's a bloody locomotive. Oh, one more part. But can I... How do I move the camera? Let's center the camera. Okay, that doesn't really... Oh, there it is. Doesn't really help me. There. I probably should be doing it from below, but I don't know. Seems to work just well when you click on these things and everything becomes transparent and you can move the camera around just like in the other simulator, which I should probably stop bloody mentioning now. Alright, so four engine mountings. Let's see if we can repair this stuff. I kind of have a sneaking suspicion that we can't. 66. Do I feel lucky? I usually don't. Oh, yeah. That's good. Engine mounting, 66. I'm going to fail some of them. That's, you know, that's maths. It's 66. Electric motor mounting brackets, 100%. Oh, yes. Should probably spend some money upgrading my workbenches if I'm going to be doing this. 66. This one will probably fail according to, yep. And this one, we'll see if we're lucky or not. But we've already saved quite a bit of money by repairing those ones. Yeah, we're definitely in the plus now. Attempt to repair completed. Ah, you can't try to repair it again. Only this workbench. Oh, you can... Ah, you can access all the other ones, I guess. Right, so we need one engine mounting. Mechanical parts. Mount. Engine mounting. 1600. Man, this stuff is expensive. But it is for huge machines, so it makes sense. And they probably have to be very, very heavy duty. Oh, yeah. Wait a second. Oh, yeah. There's a bad one. I can probably sell it. Look at how nice this one looks. What did I want to say? I wanted to say something interesting. For a change. But, I forgot now. That's unfortunate. Alright, let's put that. And then on the back, we need another mounting. There we go. Gotta wait for all those screws to appear before you can do anything. I like the fact that I don't have to be pixel specific. You know, despite the fact that I'm pretty zoomed out, the game is being pretty nice to me. How do I center the camera? Do I do this? Ah, I see. I look at the part, the exact part I want, and then you press F, and that will allow you to zoom in on that specific part. That's cool. Where's the holes? There's no holes on this model. I forgot that. Man, I'm enjoying this. Why am I enjoying doing work like this? I don't know. Probably because I guess we all wanted to be train drivers as kids or something. Or maybe I'm just weird. I don't know. That's a funny thing, though. Are there any train drivers watching this? There might be. I don't know. And they're probably saying, what an absolute pillar this is. He doesn't even know that that bracket is called that. Har har har. And yes, fair enough, you got me. There we go, I can zoom in like this. Oops. But man, if I could drive a train, that would be awesome. It's crazy to think that there's so many hundreds and hundreds of tons, you know, just rolling around on the track. I mean, rolling around, rolling forward. And it's being pulled by one, well, sometimes more, but usually by one locomotive. With actually not that great traction on the wheels because it's just, you know, metal on metal. But of course, noodles and oodles of torque from those electric engines. It's crazy. And it's so ridiculous when you hear, you know, oh yeah, the train had to do an emergency stop. All the brakes were put on and it took like, I don't know, 10 kilometers to stop or something. And then they said, oh, how fast was it going? Oh, about 30 miles per hour. And for some reason, I mixed both kilometers and miles per hour. There you go. I'm being, I don't know, globalized. There we go. That's finished. Nice. That can roll out. Income, bonus for complete achievement, bonus for low cost. Look at that. If I get pretty much double the money. Is that all the money I'm really getting? Where am I getting the money for all the parts then? Anyway, thank you so much for watching. I hope you're enjoying this. This is going to be a lot of fun, I think. I hope you're going to join me for the next part as well. And yeah, check out my other series and stuff. I'll see you next time. Have a good one. Bye-bye.